They're finally kind of teams nursing themselves back to health. And 5 minutes into the game, you lose, well, you lose a guy in warm-ups, and then you lose another guy 5 minutes into the game. And I'm speechless how this is going. We can't find a way to get guys back. It's too bad.
Jonathan, you aggravate something or something?
Yeah, I gotta, I'll find out more now, but I think so, yeah.
Did Allie, did you aggravate what he did before?
Again, there's the key to the game, so at that point you're just looking to say, okay, is he coming back or is he not? And he tried to come back. Maybe played one shift and two shifts, one and a half shifts at the end, but he couldn't do it.
You don't know how long he's at.
I don't know.
I mean, we've talked so much this year about you play well, you do good for us, you create, and you only get one in. Are you ready to pull your hair out of this?
Well, I don't have much to pull out, so it's tough because the guys gave a phenomenal effort tonight, and it just seems that we've thrown a few wins here together in our last 10. It would have been nice to get this one and kind of jumpstart our road trip, but I can't keep standing up here saying I can't believe we didn't walk away with it. We walked away 0 points in that game. And it feels like every time we lose a game, that's what I'm saying. And I thought the guys deserved a better fate tonight, but ultimately, we need to get more than one. And you can't depend on the goaltender every single night to give up one or less. Two or less give you a chance to win a game, but you give up three, then I've said this before, you're kind of teetering like you're going to win a game. But I can't tell you how many games this year we've given up two goals or less and lost. And not only lost, we got 0 points on it. That's just the end of the most
point. How concerning is that? I mean, you mentioned no points for moral victory.
Yeah, well, clearly it's a concern because it's not October anymore. Christmas is right around the corner, and all of a sudden, now we're looking at the dog days of come January, February, and we're going the wrong way in standings.
How much do you really have to trust them?
But this is not, these aren't situations where we're rushing guys back. I think it's the other thing. Well, part of it's on them because regardless of what happens, in the end, if scans and all these other things look good, now you have to go to the player. If our guys, we don't want them coming back because we don't want the same things happening again and again and again. But the players want to play. And they go through strings of tests and doctors, and everybody said, okay, well, they're clear to play. Now it's up to the player. But you can't. It's weird how these things are happening. Johnson gets hurt 48 seconds into his first shift and his first game back, completely different injury. They can protect against that. And some of these freak things are happening are extremely frustrating. And they happen really early in games too. So now everybody's kind of scrambling around a little bit. But we've had to play with a lot of call-ups all year. I'm not sure what our man games lost is, but I'm sure it's on the higher end of what's going on. But every time these guys have come up, they've done really, really well. And by no means did we get our show run tonight. I thought we had the lion's share of the chances. Their goalie made the saves he had to make, and that's probably why you watched two top tier goalies in the league play tonight, and that's why they're top tier goalies.
Scoring the team wide issue. Stamkos losing line mates left and right, it seems like, to set him up. But no goals in 8 games, like 6 shots in 5 games. And what do you see from this game? What can you do to kind of get him more, opportunities?
Injuries have created different line mates for him. It's created different line mates for everybody. And, going with Black Kooch tonight. Black gets hurt 3 minutes in. So now you're jumping guys around. And it's tough when we're not just talking about Stamkos, we're talking about everybody. Nobody's got chemistry because it's hard to keep the chemistry because so many guys are getting hurt. And ultimately you're putting your go-to guys together, and they got one tonight on the power play, but we needed one more. And it's not like they're not trying. The guys are putting themselves in good spots, and Stammer had, I think, some decent looks tonight. He set some guys up. We had a ton of great A's tonight. In the third period, we were pushing. You know, Nesty's got one, you know, on a tee for him, and he blows it wide, and it's just, that's the way it's going. You know, Cooch had one there. Marchie had one. You know, these are pucks that these guys put in on a regular basis that are going in. And, you know, it takes a perfect shot of Cooch's on the power play just for us to score. And right now, we're not getting those prototypical greasy ones. And, you know, we've got the net front, it gets tipped wide, or it pops bouncing there, and instead of bouncing right, it bounces left. And because it's really frustrating. As I said earlier, it's we're not in game 5 or 10 anymore. Now we're approaching game, we're in the 30s, and